Okay, the next award we are moving on to is the Best Musical Theatre Performance. It's sponsored by the Battery Parade Cafe. Ginny is constantly telling me how much her staff break into song and dance throughout their shifts, led by Amber. So, Ginny has requested to lead a musical theatre number in the next show, a mother and son piece with Thomas. The top five musical theatre nominees are...
But I will have her finish.
And she does a good strange but special and most peculiar mademoiselle. It's a pity at the scene, she doesn't quite fit in. She really is a funny girl, a beauty but a funny girl. She really is a funny girl.
By the Battery Parade. And the winner of Best Musical Theatre Piece is... What's Up, You Lot? Everybody, What's Up, You Lot? Come and get a
performance. So, thanks for everyone who voted for me, because that means a lot. And Duloc is basically me. I didn't have to act really, because it was just like comedy. And if you know me, I'm very funny. So, thanks for this award, and thanks for Chris and everyone who choreographed it. And Mum! And Rosie! Right,
well done, everybody. Thank you very much. You lot, well done. Okay, so we're moving on to the Continuity Award. This, I believe, is straight to a winner. So the Continuity Award is a yearly award with no nominations. It's teacher chosen. It's someone who's continually and constantly given their all in every class and every show. So the Continuity Award for 2021 is...
Thank you.
Music Award is... Misha Little.
I want to thank all the staff and my mum and Danny. Have a great night.
Well done, Misha. Thank you. The nominations for Best Onstage Partnership are... Onstage partnership goes to Just Wales and Travis Ledley.
Half of us. So me and Travis, we play quite a lot of roles together now, starting with Ryan Sharpie, Beetlejuice and Lydia, Dolly Parton and Kenny Rogers. And I'm sure there'll be plenty more next year. It's been a pleasure growing up together and now on stage together.
I really like Kenny Rogers and Dolly Parton because I do love a bit of country. And it was great! Hooray!
Oh, God, sorry. Fine.
Give me a round of applause while they get sat down. Good, well done. Well done. Best comedy performance is next, and comedy performance is awarded for being funny. There is so much variety, it really does depend on your sense of humour, so you will see different senses of humour within the nominations. But the top four comedy performance nominated are...
Getting
And the winner, Best Comedy Performance, is... A Midsummer's Nightmare! Liam, that's you!
So, I thank everyone for voting for us for this award, and that's all I've got to say other than, oh yeah!
Anyone else want to speak?
No. Great.
Yep. Thank you, well done guys! I tell you what, I couldn't shut you up last year, all of you. It's been very short and sweet this year. The best actor or actress in a supporting role is next. You've probably heard us say in the past, kids will have heard this, there are no small parts, only small actors. This is massively true and something that we try to educate each child on when they do get cast in certain roles. The next category is best actor and actress, as I've said, in supporting role. These characters assist the main characters with sometimes going off to create their own, even their own storyline within the piece. So the nominations for best actor or actress in a supporting role are... So it's 3 from 2020 and 3 from 2021, in which two soloists will obviously take the prize. So, the nominations for Vocalist of the Year are...
Where's the young? the house.
But you've all been murdered! My husband! My kids!
Calm down, girls. Oh, I don't think so. Little Missy said, besides, you have more fun than Ava. Your judge can say it's winning.
Wait, let me get this straight. You like Ava, but Ava likes Jim.
Yeah.
Jim likes Winnie.
Yeah.
And Winnie likes you.
Yeah.
But he likes me.
No one. Maybe that's why.
Where's the bedroom?
Wait, two bedrooms upstairs, but you haven't seen all the downstairs yet.
Come on,
you can't go up there on your own.
Why? Is there a good start from fit?
Yes.
No, look, that's not the point. What's the point then? I just like...
Nice sushi, guys!
Yeah, come on.
You like to make people feel like...
Oh, my God.
And the scene of the year for 2020 goes to...
I thoroughly enjoyed performing it. It's wonderful actors, so thank you for making it good. I hope you all have a great Christmas and a happy new year. Thank you.
That was a good part.
Scene of the year for 2021 is...
Thank you guys for voting for us, and thanks for Chris for the suit. I'm wearing the same suit. It was absolutely amazing acting with these guys. Mint actors, amazing. Yeah, cheers. And thank you for my beautiful family that's over there, yeah. Mint.
Thanks. Neve, where's Neve Bellion? Oh, was she in the last one? Neve, come back.
Yeah, you can go.
I've done so well.
Give me a sec.
Hello.
You're dancing. What are you dancing to? My voice? But that's rubbish, is it? You like it? Da 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 da. That was a bit good. So, Neve Bellew has been honoured with something very special. Well, I think it's an honour. You might be like, that's stupid. But we had a letter arrive at the studio, the new studio after the lockdown, and it said, girls, can you not come on stage? I love you, but can you not? Beautiful. Neve was given a letter by the Whitby Town Council, who said, we have seen your performance of Vera Lynn's We'll Meet Again. which reached over 3,000 people on the Whitby VE page. So they have asked me to present to you, on behalf of the mayor, a framed letter from the town council to thank you for services to Whitby. Well done. Now the almost important one, dancer. Oh no, wait, I'm not doing that, am I? No. I'm doing Young Performer of the Year. So actor and actress will be coming up shortly, but Best Young Performer is the next category. So the nominations for Best Young Performer of the Year are... Let me take you so you should be able to work out who has been nominated. Dancer of the Year, as follows. Rachel Dantin and L. Chick. The winner for 2020 is...
I wasn't expecting this. I'm shaking again. Wow. Thank you so much for this. I want to thank everyone, and especially Amber, because she's basically made me improve everything. And I wish you all a Merry Christmas. Thank you.
Thank you, Mia. Well done. And the winner for 2021 Dancer of the Year is...
from when I was 2 years old and to now, and then I'd like to thank Chanel and Amber for continuing it, so thank you very much.
Well done, Rob.
Okay, now this is do I have a video for this one? Yeah, I do, don't I? Yeah. Okay, this person deserves this award because she is someone who has given so much time to Colebrooke since last year. She will hence be known, this will be given away when I say this, she will hence be known as the Blind Card Queen. Yeah. Having raised a staggering £700 since the start of lockdown on her blind cards alone for the Colebrooke PTA Fund, I look forward to debating with PTA how we spend that money next year, but Parent of the Year, please put your hands together for the one and only Mandy Hutchinson. Mandy some flowers, one for her. Big round of applause for Mandy. Yeah. Parent of the Year 2021. Okay, we're moving on now to the one that the bigger ones are waiting for. Actor and Actress of the Year. So here are the top 10 voted for by the public. Actor and Actress of the Year.
Thank you.
award. I'm really grateful for you all voting for me. I'd like to give a big shout out to Chris, the best acting teacher, not only in town, in the world. So yeah, thank you all so much. Really appreciate it.
Actress of the Year 2021 is...
I'd just like to say a special thanks to Chris for having so much faith in me for all the time I've been here, especially in acting. And I feel like in the past year I've come on a lot compared to what I used to be. So thank you everyone for voting. I hope you all have a lovely night.
Okay, so we're going to do the best overall section. There's two awards left to present. One very special one, but before we do that, we're going to do best overall section. So, there's been many sections in the Colebrooke shows. Toy Story, Aladdin, Shrek, Les Mis. The top three voted for, we tried to keep it shorter than we have done in the past with these videos. So we invite everybody to watch with pleasure the overall section. Overall section, nominations are...
Thank you.
section of the year, from Dolly to Harry Potter and Star Wars, the winner is... Harry Potter. I would like Elise, Ava, Phoebe, Neve Eden, and Rosie Young to collect the award for Harry Potter.
Without me for helping him out. And yeah, it was a really good piece. Yeah. I would like to shout out Eve Barnard for wearing her costume, which was the wig, and no one else would have done it, so credits to you, Barnard.
Credits to me. This is actually thanks, guys. Well done.
Okay, so just before we come on to the last award, I just want to do my thank yous now so we can do the last award and then we can party on until we are content. So I'd like to thank you for what I think has been a great night. You probably feel it's been 18 hours of pure, you know, whatever, but I've enjoyed it. Firstly, I'd like to thank you all for coming out tonight and looking as beautiful as you do, because you do, you look good. You do. Give yourself a round of applause for looking as stunning as you do. You all scrub up very well. Even you, Colin. I wouldn't be where I am today without a lot of people. So I'd like to just quickly thank them. I know I've got a bit of paper today, but I won't be very long. I'd like to thank Sarah Young for making the most fantastic raffle I've ever seen. Where is she? Is she outside? Oh, woman in action. She's done a marvellous job and I couldn't be more grateful for her. I'd like to thank Charlene for this wonderful balloon arch that you've seen. I hope you all take as many pics as you can with that after this. I'd also like to mention a couple of other parents that have helped throughout the year, and that's of course Deb and Leslie, who always run my front of house at the shows. So thank you, Deb Parker and Leslie Wood, and of course the wonderful, honourable lady Mandy Hutchinson. Thank you, Mandy. I wouldn't be able to do it without the talented teachers that I have. So first of all, I'd like to thank my partner, my lifelong friend, not you, Josh. Amber, thank you so much, Amber. I can't express the hardship that Amber has having to put up with me all the time, so I'm really, really grateful. She's always been understanding about how this job ties me to so many things. I mean, some of you message me at 9:30 at night and I answer and she's there waiting for attention, but I answer you. I know. So I just want to say a big thank you and I love you. My other partner and best friend that anyone could wish for, and the most unkept affair, Josh Harrison. From everything you see around you, the wall of fame, the table centres, if you went to the studio, everything you see in the studio, he's done it all. He is absolutely fantastic. So please give him a big round of applause. Elle Busby, she does all my vocals and all my singing. I have the utmost respect for Elle. She works 50 to 60 hours a week at running and managing Harry's, and she still finds the time to do my vocals and all my show work, and I couldn't do it without her. So Elle, I love you lots. Thank you so much. My newest member of the team this year is Rebecca. Is Rebecca still here? Where is she? Where's Rebecca?
Cecilia. There she's there. I've worked with Rebecca for about 5 years at the LP Dance Centre, and I don't usually pride myself in my decisions, but asking Rebecca to come with me in 2020 was the best decision, one of the best decisions I ever made. So Rebecca, thank you for your unwavering support to Ballroom and Colebrooke. Thank you very much. You're dying to come on stage, aren't you? It's soon, I promise, it's soon. Then, of course, I'd like to thank my mum, Kerry. I've got to say, my mum has been my biggest support this year through getting the studio and everything, so I really, really appreciate her. It's been great to see my mum flourish again, because I feel like she's been on a mission to prove herself, and she never needed to, because she's done some fantastic work, and I'm sure you all agree, 97 out of 100 for a kid is fantastic. So, mum, thanks very much. My sister, Chanel, who I doesn't need any introduction, she's actually just kept me going through the whole thing. From the whole studio move she's been in, she got messy, she painted some benches, painted some lockers. She then starred in her own Chuckle Brothers sketch by trying to remove the 35-year-old sunbed we had in the studio. So thanks, Chanel. Chanel, again, she works really hard through the week, so she comes up from a 37-hour week, 40-hour week, comes up to the studio just to teach your kids, because she loves it so much, and we all do. So thank you, Chanel, for what you do. Last but not least, she probably thought she was getting away with it, is Valerie. So, yeah, Valerie, thank you. Valerie, you've taught me to dance for over 20 years. We've had a private lesson nearly every week, and I've got to say I've never enjoyed one. And neither have you. Me and Valerie go way back, and in her lessons when I was about 8, I'd be sent out for being naughty. And then she'd say, "Kerry, he's done nothing, take him away." I'd be sat on the stairs with a mad on with a face on. But no, I've got some fantastic memories of Valerie. One of them being when I was about 8, 9 in 2004. We went to the grand finals at Blackpool. Because if you didn't know, I was a championship dancer. Yeah, I was. So, not anymore. Retired. So, we went to Blackpool. My nan took me. God bless my nan. My mum didn't go because she was on her honeymoon from her 6th wedding. Nah, I'm joking, it was her first and her last. So my poor nan took me to Blackpool, and we got to a recall or a final, whatever it was, and I was tired because it was really long days. So my nan said, "Come on, we'll go to the top of the tower, have a look round, maybe go on rides or something." So it was me chugging away on a little dinosaur ride at the top of the tower, and the final's getting called downstairs. And I've heard it from very reliable sources that Valerie was at the side of the competition floor looking like she'd soiled herself. "Where is Christopher? Where is Christopher?" And sending everybody manning his dog to come and find me. But Valerie, you are a star. And you would remind us every day at LMP what a great star that you were. You walked into LMP and said, "Ode to Valerie." But she wasn't just LMP, she wasn't just L, she was Laws and Paige, and she was the best boss you could ever have asked for. And I can say that because Jill's not here tonight. So, you could go to her with anything and, you know, she'd listen. She probably wasn't caring, but she'd listen. So, Valerie, on behalf of all the people here, performers and otherwise, I just want to say, from Amber, Chanel, Rebecca, my mum who's taught this idea for 25 years, we've known you so long, the days at LMP, I hope that life is as good to you, Valerie, as you have been to us. Because you've got a charm and a warmth and a class, and people think a lot about you. I've met a lot of professionals in my time,
And yeah, please do stand. I've met a lot of professionals in my time, and she's introduced me to professionals, but no one has ever come quite like Valerie. So remember, when the light goes on, not only as a dance teacher, but as a human being, you make everyone feel very special at home. And we love you, and we thank you for everything you've done.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, I just like to say from the bottom of my heart, thank you. Thank you. I can see Mr. Laws is making faces. So, but he's made faces for 40 odd years. So, I'm just sorry that my own mum isn't here tonight. If I'd known you were going to make a presentation... Oh, my goodness. Well, anyway, thank you, people of Whitby. It's wonderful to see you all here tonight. And it's marvellous that Christopher is carrying on. I'm sure that dancing in all forms will be continued on for many, many years. I'm afraid to say that I do recognise a lot of you who I taught as children, and now you're grandmas. So, you know, it's what goes round comes around. You only get in, you only get out what you put in. So good luck, everyone. Thank you. Merry Christmas. And Chanel.
Come on, Isaac.
So, we'd like to present...
When Chanel gets here.
We'd like to present, as a family, the Angela Chapman Memorial Award, which is the highest honour that we can give at Colebrooke. So... we'd like you to watch the Angela Chapman Award with great pleasure. So thank you very much.
Things that I've seen in classes that she's been doing have just been fantastic. From being Madame Hooch in the Harry Potter piece in Showheads, she just showed us exactly what she can do. So definitely well deserved for me. Well done.
Congratulations, Eve, on winning this award. Your positivity is infectious. I cannot think of anyone who deserves this award more than you. Congratulations again, Eve. Really deserve it.
Angela Chapman CV.
Congratulations, Eve, on winning the Angela Chapman Award. You are the second person after the good old Liam Hutchinson to win, and you couldn't be more of a deserving winner. So I just want to say thank you for everything that you've done for Colebrooke in last year. From all of your acting, all the way to all of your dancing, which I know Chanel is thrilled by, I just want to say congratulations, and it's thoroughly, thoroughly deserved.
actually a lot more versatile than we first thought, and you can really tell that she's just getting improving and improving more and more. Her attitude is brilliant, so positive, always warm, and personally I think she really deserves the award, so congratulations.
I believe that Eva and that Mikael won, because she's a very dancer. She's great at what she does. She gives confidence on stage, and she's all around a nice person.
Over the last few years, Eva has literally gone from strength to strength. Like, in all the shows now, she's just like... not only is she an amazing pupil, she's also the nicest kind of person I've ever met. She's so nice, she's so caring, she's so helpful, and I couldn't think of anyone better to meet.
Somewhere.